Dicoletto in the alternate set of the Pierce Racing colours. The lights are on. Racing and Superior Smile Media Baron will be amongst the last when they get going, and Shark Mouth and Swift Platinum amongst the first to go. Also out very quickly, Triple Event firing across and pushing up Dicoletto, and Lord Ludlow's going to press on and be right on speed. Further back behind them, about sixth, is Scarlet Missile when they get going. Two lengths, Universal May, Paradise Square, Strata Creed in the back half of the field with Debellatio, and also when they settle down, Superior Smile. Third from last, Tycoon Target back there with Rosa Shadow, and the Grey Media Baron down on the inside is next to last. At the 750 in Triple Event, found the rails, had to do plenty of work being there, however, and out by three quarters over the Grey, Swift Platinum, Lord Ludlow on the rails third, Shark Mouth is three deep, a length away Dicoletto, nice and handy for Pike coming into the corner, just wants to race in patches though, he's starting to dig him up, and then came Scarlet Missile about to let loose around them from Debellatio, Paradise Square, Universal May, Strata Creed finding room between horses into the home straight. 300 left to go, Triple Event, Swift Platinum, Scarlet Missile burst up on the outside to grab them from Strata Creed. Lord Ludlow getting a run now, Dicoletto down the outside, Debellatio, Paradise Square, Scarlet Missile the leader, Pike is driving, Big Fellow, Dicoletto on his inside, Dicoletto arrived, Dicoletto in the nick of time from Scarlet Missile, Pike wins the last again, Paradise Square or Debellatio there for third, and right on there, Hammer as well, Strata Creed, Lord Ludlow, Universal May. And then came deeper out, Tycoon Target, Media Baron, past a few stragglers, Superior Smile, Rosa's Shadow, Swift Platinum, Shark Mouth as well, and Triple Event, who'd cut up noticeably after leading for home to finish back there amongst the last in. Dicoletto. Pike really had to muscle the Big Fellow up. He wanted to switch off and switch on in running. And Pike, conscious of that, there just kept digging and working away at Dicoletto. Scarlet Missile zipped around them, dashing to the front after straightening. But Pike wouldn't give up on this big guy by Dick Turpin. And third run in, blinkers on, Dicoletto for Dan and Ben Pierce. Salutes from Scarlet Missile. Paradise Square will be third in front of Debellatio. So it's Dicoletto home for Danelle Pierce, R. Vitey, Ms. P. Wood, D. Norris, Glenn McTaggart, E. Sherry, and also G. Coucher, KB Parsons, and P. Salmiri, Dick Turpin, Storm Leto, Gelding. Three wins now from eight. And Pike, they had him nice and handy fifth in running, but he's still pretty raw. He's green. He's still got lots to learn about the craft there. And Pike's brilliance gets him home to win the last of the day. Okay, we'll get to the yard now, and Gareth joining us, and it looked as though there was a little push too from the yard there for Dicoletto in that last event.
Yeah, he's a busy man, Macca. I bet he's got to strap Dicoletto as well today, but Pike in the last, he rode Dicoletto a treat, and the horse did the rest today.
Yeah, he's not an easy horse. You see the work Willie had to do there throughout the race, picking him up and getting him on the bridle, travelling, and but yeah, got the job done. He dug in the last 100.
How far can he go? Is he still learning the caper here, Benny?
He is still learning, and like what he showed us early on, we expect a lot from him, and I think we were a bit disappointed when he didn't give it, but then you've got to forgive him a bit because he is so inexperienced.
And he is the son of Dick Turpin, one of the best probably going around, Dicoletto.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, no, he's daddy didn't help him, but he's getting the job done.
Where does he go to next?
Just these sort of races. We'll just try and pick off a few of these and see what he can do.
Good luck strapping him on the way home now. Good luck.
I hope he doesn't make me work as much as he did on the way in.
He might be a little bit tired now. You never know what I'm Benny.
Thanks.
There's Ben Pierce there, Brittany. And Scarlet Missile was brave back in second. Paradise Square third. And Debellatio was a good run, never really off on the track there to finish fourth.
And that's the case that we've seen so often today with those barriers just making races really difficult. Debellatio, one that had drawn out wide and just couldn't manage to get in and find a spot, which has made it difficult for a number of horses today that we thought could be a main fancy. But Pike, to his credit, he really deserved this one. We see him win the last so often, but he really had to muscle this horse, not just during the race, but we spoke about him before as well, in that he had to run along the track and swing himself on just to get Dicoletto out. Obviously, those blinkers on, the tongue tie on for the first time today, perhaps just a new experience for Dicoletto. shadow and not wanting to head out onto the track, but it was no problem once he was out there because Pike was able to muscle him to victory today.
Pike in the last, it's just quite unbelievable sometimes.
Like it's becoming ridiculous.
Yeah. It is ridiculous, really, isn't it? Because he's done it again at Bunbury. He did it again, I think, at Ascot the other day.
It's becoming a thing where you legitimately, your form reference is Pike
Dicoletto
in the last.
Was in your top three? He's not one of my horses, Dicoletto, because he is hard to catch.
He is a bit hard to catch. He was obviously going to be a chance today with the blinkers going on. You always know that there can be that element of improvement. They made that gear change with the tongue tie as well. So they were obviously tweaking a few things. But he's a horse with such an extravagant action that he's a funny one. You can't miss him in the run, that's for sure. We'll catch up with Pikey now, who, yet again, we're speaking after the last. And this one really made you work for it today.
Yeah, he did. I fell asleep and missed the boat on the corner and made things difficult for myself. But lucky he had enough juice in the tank to get there for me.
To the eye, his action looks so extravagant. Do you feel that in running?
Yeah, definitely. He's actually quite difficult to ride and quite difficult to judge. But when he's doing those great big bounds and getting his head in front, it's kind of funny. He makes you smile.
Did you even draw the whip, or was it all hands and heels to the line?
No, it was all hands and heels. He's got that big gangly action. I was hoping not to have to use it, and I didn't have to. He's finishing strong. He was always interested today. And, if I aided him a little better on the turn, I think he would have looked a little smarter.
Well, it was smart enough. You got the win. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, well done to William Pike winning the last race there today at Ascot. Brittany Taylor now joins us.